so sad for you.
Yeah, he left me again.
He did.
He dumped me again.
Are you upset?
Well, I'm not upset because I have you.
Oh,
I hear you. So
nice. You know what?
What?
I'm going to make it so much better right now. You are not going to do this by yourself.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh. My goodness.
I want you to stand right here.
Wow.
You can do.
The doctor.
You know what?
Yeah.
This is how I usually cook in a suit like
there
this, and I'll help you out.
I've never seen anybody photograph like you either. I mean, you know,
not just a doctor, a hot doctor.
Yeah, right.
Oh, my goodness. Are you going to help me cook this?
Yeah, I am. Okay. I'm not really sure what any of these things are, but okay. I see spices over there in Turkey.
Do you eat meat?
Yes.
Okay. Oh. Well, then we're getting along just fine now.
Let's do okay. this. Let's do this thing.
All right. Is it time for our fun jet vacation?
It
first?
Is time for our fun jet okay. vacations, isn't it? Right, here we go. It's our weekly Fun Jet Dream Vacation Sweepstakes. You could win a getaway for two to Cancun with all-inclusive accommodations at the Riu Palace, Las Americas, courtesy of Fun Jet Vacations. Do something you'll never, ever forget, like what Christina's doing right now. You're combining the tradition of luxury and style with beautiful beachfront surroundings.
Really
the Riu Palace, Las Americas is a five-minute walk from shopping, dining, and entertainment in Cancun's hotel zone. Enjoy richly appointed guest suites featuring a private balcony, all-inclusive restaurants, opulent spa services, and an exciting selection of unique activities. The Riu Palace at Las Americas is the perfect choice for travelers seeking romance and relaxation. All you need to do is listen for the two clue words that we're giving away in the show once you've identified both of those. You sail on over to our website, hallmarkchannel.com/homeandfamily, and you use those words to enter. Enter once each single day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. All the rules are on. I love Justice Improv. Over there. Go to our website.
Mayonnaise.
All the details are there.
Is that what this is?
It's mayonnaise. You made your own mayonnaise there, doctor.
There.
All right.
Do you know what he said to me while we were dancing? Huh. He said, "Are you trying to lead?"
It wasn't
yeah,
clear.
Yeah, see, but the guys in the book, it wasn't clear to
it
you?
It was not clear, sorry.
Well, good right. doctor. Okay.
So what's so sloppy about Sloppy Joe's?
Well, it's very messy. We're going to bring it in and you'll see. Bring it in, please. Yes, we have one for you, doctor, too.
We never found the origin of where Sloppy Joe's started.
No, but I'll find out where Sloppy Joe's, perhaps if anyone out there, leave it on our Facebook page where the origin of Sloppy Joe's started, and we'll read it and we'll...
Maybe it was Sloppy Ben.
Maybe there were sloppy guys. Well, okay.
Wow.
So we're going to raise the bar a little bit on this because, doctor, we're going to be making this with some turkey, some dark meat turkey instead of beef, so we're trying to take a little bit of the fat off of it, and we're going to add chipotle and chilies and jalapeno and corn and beans just to make it tasty. And it's really easy to do. But here's a little trick that I like. I take the buns
and
toast them up, and I'll take the insides out to make like a little bowl, because you know if you put all of that meat on top, then for sure it's sloppy and it just absolutely goes everywhere. So I just take the inside and make a little resting place for the turkey.
It's a turkey swimming pool.
Yeah, it's a little pool. You're right. It's a little third dimensional. It's not a chalk drawing, but it's third dimensional. All right.
Hey, thanks for waiting for us over there, guys.
Yeah. You know, it tastes a lot better than that.
You know what? Why don't we bring the doctor his turkey?
Fine. No, okay. I'm really into the swimming pool thing.
You are? Okay.
The swimming pool
thing. All right.
This is a brand swimming pool.
All right, so we're going to make the coleslaw.
There you go.
We'll make the coleslaw first, doctor. Since you made the mayonnaise, why don't you put it into the coleslaw? I like to put coleslaw in the Sloppy Joe because here's a spatula for you.
Great. I can improvise.
So, there you go. So, it gives it a really nice crunch. And to that, we're going to add the peanuts, the cilantro, some salt, and some lemon juice. And I have a little bit of cayenne pepper. Mm. Wow. So you put that in there. You can mix that all up and we'll set it aside. In the meantime, while you're doing that, doctor, I've never had such a good-looking person in the kitchen.
Easy.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's
you know,
like...
That's easy.
Okay. I mean, yes. Okay.
I'm disappearing by the moment.
No, don't. You can never vanish.
See you later.
Never. You can never
Patrick
vanish.
Swayze and Ghost.
No. Doctor, this is for
right
you.
Right here to me. I'm right here.
This is yours right there. Thank you.
Okay,
you mix that up.
Now, is this all measured out properly? Is this enough here?
Yes, you can put that in there, and then you have cilantro, lemon juice, and a little
bit.
You have just a pinch of salt, not all of it. Now, I have some onions over here that I am sauteing with some scallions. You'll saute that for about 3 or 4 minutes until it starts to caramelize. And then you're going to add your turkey meat. You'll cook the turkey meat until, I'm gonna add a little bit of salt over here.
I'll take a pinch as instructed.
Good, yes. Yeah. Yes, you listen, yes. A little bit of salt on it. And you're going to cook this for at least 10 minutes or until, oh, wow, that cayenne is hot, until it starts to caramelize. And you want to bring the natural juice of the turkey out, and when it caramelizes too, it brings out a sweetness to the meat. So we're going to pretend that this is already caramelized, and then to that, we're going to add things like fresh corn from Corn on the Cob. You can shuck it. I have some black beans, some ketchup. The ketchup gives it a really lovely flavor. It brightens up the flavor of the Sloppy Joes, and instead of using canned tomatoes, I have some jalapeno. I like things nice and spicy. Look how colorful and beautiful this is, Doctor. Look at this.
Wow. Nice? You know what? I'm really impressed.
Are you?
It's colorful and it's also beautiful. Yeah.
Thank you.
What I'm noticing. Good.
Yes, and I have some brown sugar that's stuck here. Just the yeah. Here, Doctor, could you unstick that for me? Maybe you could do that. I have some chipotle.
There may be a little, there you go.
There we go.
I added some.
Look at that. Of course, he did it.
Oh, look at you.
Yeah. Yeah, but see, now the problem.
Yeah, we're just smart, too, apparently.
Yeah, what's this?
Right.
I have some Dijon mustard and some chipotle.
Can anybody
adobo,
see me right now?
Yes, we
anybody see me?
Where's that handbag?
We're going to add some cumin. All of these lovely flavors will meld together. Are you tasting? Can you taste all of those flavors?
Very good.
Now, to that, you're going to add some water and let it cook down for about 5 or 10 minutes until all the flavors start to infuse. And when it's done, you'll have your mixture. Here are your buns that are toasted right here, the hollowed out ones right here. Mm-hmm. Here they are. See that? So we're going, there it is. Mm-hmm. Now, what you're going to do with it, it gets better. Watch this. I'm going to take the inside and put them in my little hole right there.
Swimming pool.
Okay, my little swimming pool. And just pile it up as high as you can. There you go. And then after I'm done doing that, I'm going to add a, Doctor, perhaps you can do it for me. If you would kindly add some cheese on top.
Of course.
On top of that.
Now, what kind of cheese do you like with this?
Well, this is a Monterey Jack cheese, but you can use a pepper jack cheese if you like.
And then?
Not yet,
okay.
Because,
all right.
Not yet, because, Doctor, what we're going to do is you put them under the broiler for about 2 minutes only, okay? And then you pull it out. There you go.
Oh, just to melt it, to make it gooey on top.
Yeah. There we go. And now, what we'll do, Doctor, is we'll take the one and put some coleslaw on top of it.
You know what, Christina, is cabbage is like tofu in that it takes on the flavor of the stuff. We talked about this the other day. It really doesn't have a whole lot of flavor, but when you use it as texture and then you flavor it the way you want it.
Exactly.
Is that right?
You can use, because you know, we've made coleslaw on this show many different ways.
Take that, Doctor.
Here, Doctor. All right. Put that on top.
That's a charity point.
There you go. Now, this one we already made for you, Doctor, and we'd like to know if you would like to take a bite and let us know. Now, it's sloppy. Don't mess up your beautiful suit.
Okay, here, I'm ready.
I like to, you know what? I almost enjoy like an open face version of this, right? Yeah. Here it is.
No one's listening.
I know. I'm not even here.
Here we go. He's going in. He's going in. He's going in.
There it is. Look at that. Look at that.
There you go. All right.
This is, he's so classy, he even knew how to take a TV bite. I would have like tried to do the whole thing and look like a fool. He did a perfect TV bite.
That's really good. Have you tried it with other types of meat too?
You can. You could use chicken, you can use pork, you can use all kinds of things of meat to make it, even fish.
Fish it is. Okay, everything's on our website, yes? Did you say that already?
Of course, everything's always on our website.
Walmartchannel.com/homeandfamily. There it is. It's on the record. It's time now to check out the amazing optical illusion of illusions of Tracy Lee Stumm, and she's created this amazing, there you are, 3D chalk art. It's outside. It's coming up right after this. La, 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 la. All right, fine.